Psychotic Pineapple's the band, but Pino Man is Pino Man. And he was obviously just became the mascot. Pino Man is just the dream anybody has of like being great and all that. But rather than going and working a regular job and having fantasies about doing famous things, he's actually trying it all the time and failing. So he's out there on the street and he thinks he's a star and he acts like a rock star and the whole thing. And, you know, people think he's crazy. And I don't know, to me it just seemed logical. It's like, okay, we have a band called Psychotic Pineapple. I come up and draw a character named Psychotic Pineapple and he has to do crazy stuff. And that was pretty much it, whatever idea I could come up with that week or whatever the show was. So now this here is the crucifix. And everybody loves that poster just because he's on the cross. So everybody's got a reaction of some sort. But I actually remember thinking consciously while I was drawing it, I mean after I'd already started drawing it, that it looked kind of like Henricus. And I remember he was going through a particularly tough time having to do with some family thing. And he was a real bitch at rehearsal for about a month. So we were having arguments just about arrangements of songs and which songs we're doing and which ones we're not doing, and everybody's frustrated.
Henry would just come in and we would be sort of against the wall, like, because he would be on a diatribe. And we'd be like, okay, Henry, but we want to rehearse.
I wanted to go get more of my songs played and, I think John and Alex were more into like the straight ahead, like Sonic type beat, you know.
That may have led to this. We felt a little bit hard to work with him at a moment, but at the same moment, it's like I think two things happened. He had some kind of brain aneurysm, some kind of explosion in a blood vessel in his head, and
it can result in a cerebral hemorrhage, which I suffered.
Thank God he survived, and he's doing great now. And unfortunately it knocked out his dexterity in his right side, so he didn't play guitar anymore.
That was kind of the point where the band stopped functioning as well, really.
Kids, don't listen to this at home. Listen to Justin Bieber.
Life. We wrote about, what do you call this, an analogy between driving and sex and danger.
John Seabury and I were at Janet Shane's house and he said, let's take acid and write a song. So we were getting high on LSD and we were like writing riffs, and these two riffs just came right together, his bass line and this guitar riff. And we were writing about Janet's car, actually, this Ford Pinto that explodes when you hit it from behind. And
actually, I always wanted to see the video for that one because it's just, it would make a nice little short little kind of horror movie. You know, that's kind of the way I see that one. I'd like to see it. Just the car screaming through the night. You know, with the terrified girl.
I've got to bring out some people. A beautiful thing that God shot out into this ugly world 38 years ago. God laid a big, beautiful turd right in front of us 38 years ago. And we've been waiting for it to steam up and rise up and show it their ugly head once again. Ladies and gentlemen, here is that beautiful turd, Psychotic Pineapple.
devil has work for idle hands.
This Mad Magazine thing with cartoon with little suburban girls, innocent girls. Her parents think they're all nice, but they're upstairs doing demonic, satanic things.
We took about 6 months to find the last line that we couldn't decide on, which ended up being the angel of the bottomless pit.
I know you've been cheating, and it's time to quit. Well, I had a talk with the angel of the bottomless pit. You ought to know when you're untrue. I'm lurking around with nothing to do. Soon I might have other plans. The devil has work for idle. Through your window, I stood at your door, and what you were saying, I knew the score. You don't want to lose any action. It's gonna cause a bad reaction. The things I do, you might not understand. The devil has work for idle hands.
Deeper would you want to go inside the head of Alex and John? Well, maybe we better just like leave it at that, right?
I forget whether it's called I Forgot Who I Was or I Forgot Who I Was. Okay.
That's fantastic.
Yeah, Forgot Who I Was is really about me being completely clueless and totally separate from what everybody else was doing. And John said reminded me I was in the bathroom when we were writing a song, and I came back and said, John, I was taking a piss and I forgot who I was. And he said, oh, okay, let's write that song.
It's like Walter Mitty or whatever. He's having fantasies because he forgot he's like not that cool.
I forgot who I was.
Going to the kitchen, look
one might say that I own Richmond Records. However, the reality of it is that the Richmond Records deal was no contract, no royalties, and no rights.
I wanna get rid of you.
Really a lot of saying, I wanna.
It's originally an idea I had, one of the first songs I tried writing, called I Want You to Want Me, to Want You to Want Me, to Want You to Want Me Too. And about a month or so after I'd written those lyrics, this band called Cheap Trick came out with a song called I Want You to Want Me. So it's like, oh, well, I guess we're not gonna do that.
Twisted version of the Everly Brothers. Just, what would they do if they were wacky like Psycotic Pineapple?
Alex!
Damn!
She was kinda nice. I took her to the Wheaties and started puking twice.
I wanna I couldn't tell you no more. I said to him, baby, you ain't no fun. Your quotient ain't equal to my lump sum.
Is simply us turning the tape recorder off.
And we were all watching this movie, The Texas Chainsaw Massacre, which inspired a lot of our songs. It was about that movie.
Fuck it, we want to sing a song.
Laird. We'll be right back.
yeah, again, that's Texas Chainsaw Massacre. One of the arch villains is really into head cheese, and Henriquez just took that over. He had a love song and said, "Oh, no, let's write about head cheese."
And he actually admitted to me that it was originally named after a girl, like Mary or something like that. But he felt kind of embarrassed about the lyrics, you know, just a love song.
Head cheese depicting my love of head cheese.
Also inspired by the Texas Chainsaw Massacre.
These guys were into, you know, unusual things.
Head cheese.
And Sabrina was our attempt to get the to do real hard garage rock like the Sonics. We love the Sonics. We got fanatic about it and did the best we could. And as I told the story before, Dan insists that every good song has got a bridge in it. So he made us write a bridge in which he suggested we use the word shimpy.
So Dan says, yeah, everybody's saying shimpy in high school right now. So we used shimpy as meaning, you know, she's a tough, cool girl or something like that. And later we realized that nobody ever used that word ever again, just in our song.
the daughter in Bewitched was named Sabrina, right?
Yeah.
Can't think of anything to say about She's Boss.
She's Boss was written for David. At the time, David was collecting a lot of records. I spent a lot of time with him around thrift stores and flea markets picking up stuff, and he grabbed this whole bunch of these albums wherever he could get them, of the 1910 Fruit Gum Company and the Katzenitz Orchestra, Yummy 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 and all that, and we thought he was really into it, so he wrote a bubblegum song for him.
They thought I was really, really attached to the bubblegum thing, so they wrote me a bubblegum song, and you know, it's fun. It's a really fun song. I like singing it, and it's just kind of, you know, kind of cute.
With the pineapple, there was never any macho rock and roll posturing.
Bye.
You're Gonna Miss Me, we took from the 13th floor elevators. Rocky Erickson wrote it. And we had the good fortune to be able to play with Rocky Erickson with this band and the Aliens in 1970 and 1980. And the first time we played with them, we were opening at the Mabuhay, and we decided not to do You're Gonna Miss Me because it was their his song and all that. But then we got an encore, we decided to do it anyway. And I was really getting into the song. It was really, you know, it was cool. I had the feeling on it and all that. At the end of the song, I walked off stage and went over to Dan, who was over by the bar, and he goes, "Who's that weird guy dancing around behind you?" And I said, "What weird guy? What are you talking about?"
He ended up with his guitar and dubbed John on both shoulders, you know, with one gig, I think, blessed us.
Dropout, that was by Roger Ruskin Spear of the Bonzo Dog Band in his band, Big Grunt. Roger Ruskin Spear is from a line of satirists. His father was dubbed the Knight, I think.
Seems to be pretty far ahead of its time for being hard rock, and in fact satirical of hard rock. In any case, that song just became Henry's.
Gave us a chance to just spaz out and play the most craze, just leaning on the keyboard and making sounds, but that was super fun, and we would actually, to me, create some of the best music of the night was just going out on something like Dropout until, you know, for minutes, making noise.
Up there. It's not, I wasn't freezing. Show off my sexy body.
What can I say? It's just a opus of heaviness and deep, intelligent thinking. Dropout, yeah. Everybody should drop out.
Fuck! Hell! Fuck! Hell!
Baby, papa, baby, drop out! We'll be right back.
hope you all learned your lesson. It's never too late to drop out.
Sort of composed on the spot by Tommy Dunbar, and then we took that and made it our own.
The Ramones could have written that at the same, you know, 1974, you know, before people were writing that stuff.
And Water So Bad was written by Tommy while we were sitting in rehearsal, and he basically just started hitting two chords over and over, and he says, now just call out after me when I sing a line, you just go, yes it was, or whatever like that. And then he made up the lines as he went along, and so he wrote it in about as much time as it took for us to play it. First song ever original for the Pino, too.
One, two, one, and never!
All right, I want to see everybody get up and move with me on this one. And put you on the red, and whatever. Well, I saw her today, and she was walking down the street. Yes, she was.
Yes, she was. She was walking down the street.
Well, she smiled at me, and my heart was out of pity.
Yes, it was. Yes, it was.
Eyes and ears and nose and lips and everything I like except the tongue. Head cheese, yummy head cheese. Has got eyes and ears and nose and lips and everything I like except I make my own. I boil the heads and bones. Then I grind it up and put it in an ice cream cone. It's good for you. My whole family eats it. Come over to our house. Time. Had you.
it's the dead cheese. It's got eyes and ears and nose and lips and everything I like except the tongue. It's got eyes and ears and nose and lips and everything I like